Romans 8, chapter 8 to 14. Please open your Bible. Romans 8, chapter 8 to 14. Are we all there? Those who are in the realm of the flesh cannot please God. You, however, are not in the realm of the flesh, but are in the realm of the Spirit. If indeed the Spirit of God lives in you, and if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, they do not belong to Christ. But if Christ is in you, then even though your body is subject to death because of sin, the Spirit gives life because of righteousness. And if the Spirit of Him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, He who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies because of the Spirit who lives in you. Therefore, brothers and sisters, we have an obligation, but it is not to the flesh to live according to it. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the misdeeds of the body, you will live. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. May God bless His Holy One. Christ offered us His friendship. As we read in John 15:14, ye are my friends if ye do the things which I command you. He is expecting us to reciprocate that unconditional friendship. Our Lord has said that He gave us, was a proof of His friendship. He gave His life for us. He now tells us what our path is to be, to do the things which He commands. He gave His life to secure a place for His love in our hearts to shepherd us. The response His love calls us to and empowers us for is that we do what He commands us. As we obey the commands, we shall know the love more fully. Christ has already said, if you keep my commandments, you shall abide in my love. He counts it needful to repeat the truth again. The one proof of our faith is His love. The one way to abide in it, the one mark of being true branches, is to do the things which He commands us. He begins with absolute surrender of His life for us. He can ask nothing less from us. This alone is a life in His friendship. This truth of the imperative necessity of obedience, doing all that Christ commands us, has not sufficient place in our Christian teaching and in our lives that Christ meant it to have. We are given a far higher place to privileges, satisfying our personal desires, satisfying our personal needs, and serving Him at our convenience than to duty. We have not considered implicit obedience as a condition of true discipleship. The secret thought that it is impossible to do the things He commands us, and the subtle and unconscious feeling that sinning is a necessity, have frequently robbed both precepts and promises of their power. If you are going to serve Christ in the Spirit, you have to live in the Spirit. You have to take the things of the Spirit very serious, because in the Spirit realm, there is no room for the flesh. As we are there at the battlefield against Satan. On the battlefield, some will be watchmen on the towers looking for the surprise attacks of the enemies. Some will be scouts and spies, like Joshua and Caleb among the 12 that Moses sent to spy the land of Canaan. Some will be archers ready to shoot the arrows, while some will carry the banner of Christ, which will replace the Ark of the Covenant.
Amen.
Each group with specific spiritual duty upon which our victory or defeat depends. So there is no question of I forget to discharge my responsibility as a watchman. If the watchman falls asleep or gets drunk while on duty, and the enemy slips through the gates while all the comrades are fast asleep, what do you think will happen? The Bible provides the answer in Ezekiel 33:1-6. He said, the word of the Lord came to me, son of man. Speak to your people and say to them, when I bring the sword against the land, and the people of the land choose one of their men and make him their watchman, and he sees the sword coming against the land and blows the trumpet to warn the people, then if anyone hears the trumpet but does not heed the warning, and the sword comes and takes their life, their blood will be on their own head. Since they heard the sound of the trumpet but did not heed the warning, their blood will be on their own head. If they had heeded the warning, they would have been saved. But if the watchman sees the sword coming and does not blow the trumpet to warn them, because he's fast asleep or drunk or careless or I don't care, and the sword comes and takes someone's life, that person's life will be taken because of their sin. But I will hold that watchman accountable for their blood. I want you to listen to me to learn the lesson of Zacchaeus, the short man, the tax collector. If Zacchaeus, the tax collector, had not decided to climb up that sycamore tree on that special day that Jesus Christ was passing by under that tree, and he thinking, I will see Jesus another day, he will have lost his salvation, as the Lord never passed through that place again. So, brothers and sisters, when it comes to the things of God, if we are really serious of getting out of our present suffering in this wilderness in which we are, and move forward towards our land of Canaan, our promised land, let us all take our responsibility serious. Amen. You must remember, we are at every moment at the battlefield, and one of Satan's tactics is to sow the seed of confusion and strike amidst us. Please.
Amen.
It is easy to disorganize any church where the Spirit of Christ is not firmly grounded. Any little insignificant misunderstanding will bring out the old garment we think we have already thrown away, and falsely deceiving ourselves that we are born again Christian, living with Christ but not living in Christ. Our own relationship with Christ has become clouded and lowered by our own assumption of righteousness and self-justification of our thoughts and actions, which has jeopardized the weight of his teaching. It has affected the power to hear and obey his voice, and through obedience to enjoy his love and friendship.
Amen.
As Christ letter to the church in Sardis is also being sent to us this morning, and we shall all read again from Revelation 3:1-6. Please open your Bible to Revelation 3, because that letter is also meant for us this morning. Revelation 3:1-6. To the angel of the church in Sardis write, these are the words of him who was the seven spirits of God and the seven stars. I know your deeds. You have a reputation of being alive, but you are dead.
Yes.
Wake up! Strange word remains and is about to die. For I have found your deeds unfinished in the sight of my God. Remember therefore what you have received and heard. Hold it fast and repent. But if you do not wake up, I will come like a thief, and you will not know at what time I will come to you. Yet you have a few people in Sardis who have not soiled their clothes. They will walk with me, dressed in white, for they are worthy. The one who is victorious.